Okay, so good morning. Today we are going to study about a new topic of English grammar, that is sentence. So whenever you speak or write something, we use a group of words. A group of words that make complete sense is called a sentence. ऐसे words जिनका लिखने के time कुछ meaning होता है. The words which deliver some information, such type of words are known as a sentence. For example, here I have written Jack Homer sat little corner in a. We can call this a sentence? No. Why? Because though these are also a group of words, but are they delivering or giving any information? No. So let me rearrange this again. Little Jack Homer sat in a corner. So can we call this a sentence? Yes. Why? Because from this sentence we are having information that Jack Homer is a boy who is sitting in the corner of a room. So based on the sense of the sentence, sentences are divided into four parts. Basically there are four parts, but one part is also additional. So based on the type of sentences, sentences are divided into four parts. First is declarative, second interrogative, third imperative, and fourth exclamatory. There is one more type which is known as optative sentences. So we are going to discuss about them one by one. First we will discuss about declarative sentences. So our first type is declarative sentences. They are basically simple positive sentences. For example, Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. It is a normal sentence. All the normal sentences come under declarative sentence. And declarative sentence always ends with a full stop. Positive sentence, negative sentence also comes under declarative sentence. For example, she was not wearing black dress. Now, how you will find that the sentence is written in negative forms? Words such as not, no, these words when written in sentence means that they are in negative form. So positive sentence, negative sentence, all such type of sentences comes under declarative sentence. And declarative sentence always ends with a full stop. Second type is interrogative sentences. Sentences which we use to ask questions, such type of sentences comes under interrogative sentences. And interrogative sentences always ends with a question mark. So if you have to guess which type of sentence is this, then if you look at the question mark, you must get in mind that it is interrogative sentence. Here I have written two examples. Who are you? So it is a question. So it would come under interrogative sentence. And as you can see, it's always ending with a question mark. Where you have been? मतलब इतने दिनों से आप कहाँ थे? So it is also a question. So it would also come under interrogative sentences. Whenever you see question mark, then you should get in mind that it's an interrogative sentence. Okay? Third type of sentence is imperative sentence. So any command, any request, or any piece of advice comes under imperative sentence. For example, stand up. So here the person is giving command, so it would come under imperative sentence. Now second is request. When you do a request, when you ask for a request, then it also comes under imperative sentence. For example, please give me your sharpener. Here the person is requesting the other person to give his sharpener. So it would also come under imperative sentence. And third is any piece of advice. Whenever you give any advice, then all such type of sentences also come under imperative sentence. For example, think before you speak or speak wisely. Any such sentence would come under imperative sentence. Imperative sentence either ends with a full stop or an exclamatory mark. It depends on the force on how you have spoken. For example, if you say silently, like stand up in a normal tone, then we would use full stop. But if you would say more forcefully, like stand up, so here we would use exclamatory mark. So in this, we can use either full stop or exclamation mark both. So fourth type of sentence is exclamatory sentence. Whenever you express your emotions such as excitement, anger, joy, wonder, etc., then all such type of sentences comes under exclamatory sentence. For example, if we say, ouch, it hurts. So here, ouch is a feeling. Here the person is feeling hurt, so it would come under exclamatory sentence. Oh, you are here. So here, oh, words such as oh, hello, happy. So all such words come under exclamatory sentence. And if you want to know that